In this problem, we have vapor liquid equilibrium, and we're giving a diagram of pressure versus mole fractions. So it's a system with an azeotrope, and it wants us to say something about the fugacity of the liquid. So what's of interest is fugacity, in this case, of benzene, which is component one in the liquid. And it's asking us to do that at two conditions. So what I've indicated is 0.3 and 0.9 liquid mole fraction. Remember, high pressure liquid, low pressure is vapor. So liquid mole fraction of 0.3 would have vapor with a mole fraction, let's say 0.45. And a liquid with a mole fraction 0.9 would have a vapor with a mole fraction, say 0.78. We don't need to measure more accurately than that. And so the question is, which has the higher fugacity? So for these pressures, which are in kilopascals, they're relatively low. And so we can assume ideal gas. That's a reasonable approximation. So that for the vapor phase, we can get the fugacity. Fugacity of benzene for X1 is 0.3. So the fugacity of benzene is going to be Y1 times the pressure, which means Y1, you see from the graphs, about 0.45, and the pressure is about 37. And for X1 equals 0.9, the fugacity would be likewise Y1 at the different condition, different pressure, Y1 0.78, and the pressure is about 34. So we don't actually have to multiply the numbers out to see that this is a bigger number. So the fugacity of B is larger at X1 equals 0.9. Now note, this is the fugacity of B in the vapor phase, but the fugacity in the vapor equals the fugacity in the liquid for benzene, because we're at vapor liquid equilibrium. That's our criteria for equilibrium. And so, answer vapor phase, the fugacity is larger for X1 equals 0.9 and for the liquid phase.